The fact is that scientists can no longer claim that animal experimentation works and that there are no alternatives. There are alternatives. More non-animal research methods are used in laboratories today than actually using animals. The scientists who use animals are in the minority. We've witnessed great progress over the last three decades, but it has, as I mentioned, been followed by a huge rise in the use of animals, and this has been the result of the introduction of genetically modified animals. Bounced by this use of genetically modified animals, this little backwater of scientists who still want to use animals because their careers depend on it, have fought back very, very hard. During the last 8 years, there has been development of European legislation on animal experimentation, and that campaign has taken up almost all of our efforts. We fought hard, we fought long, we made lots of gains during the course of that campaign. And then during the debates in Parliament, we also lost a lot with a massive onslaught from the pharmaceutical industry. There were times during the debate in the European Parliament when there were more lobbyists from the pharmaceutical industry than there were members of the European Parliament. To every two anti-vivisection lobbyists, there were 10 pharmaceutical industry lobbyists. And this is something that we have to take on board. But remember that they may have the numbers, but we are right. And we don't go away, and we have the will.